to my study channel Nastudy. Myself Nazneen Akka. Today my video is on nomenclature. So what is nomenclature? Nomenclature is the scientific naming of often living organisms. Either it may be plant or animal or microorganisms, whatever which is exist in this world, they are given a scientific name. Before, the name was given vernacular or local name. In local and vernacular, vernacular is a local name. When it was given, so it is not easily recognized by any other part of the area, any part of the world. Why? Because it is not meant that if the name of this particular plant, for example, if it is here, it doesn't mean the same name will be in the different part of the world or different part of the area. It can be called by another name. So it is very important to give the scientific name. If the scientific name was there, then it is easily recognized all over the world with one name. That's why the scientific name or nomenclature was established. So what is nomenclature? Nomenclature is the scientific naming of living organisms, either plant, animal or organisms. When I speak about the plant, it is called as plant nomenclature, or it's called as botanical nomenclature. So nomenclature is what? Is the scientific naming of plant, animal or microorganism. It relates with the living organism. And if I speak about in the plant, then it covers botanical nomenclature or botanical nomenclature or plant nomenclature, because here I am talking about the naming of plant. So I am saying about as plant nomenclature. Before, it was there, the name was there with local or vernacular name. Vernacular or local name. But it will not accepted everywhere with this name. Now this name nomenclature can become as a polynomial, trinomial or binomial, but most accepted one is your binomial nomenclature. In the binomial nomenclatures, it was first given by Carlos Nias, and it was in this the two name were given. One is called as a generic, another one is called as a specific. Generic name came from genus and specific is name is from species. So what we come to, what is binomial nomenclature? Now come to binomial nomenclature. In binomial nomenclature, it was first proposed or given by Carlos Linnaeus. Carlos Linnaeus. He was Swedish naturalist. Naturalist in the year 1751. So binomial nomenclature, according to binomial nomenclature, it was the nomenclature of any living organism was categorized into two names. One is with generic name. Another one is characterized with specific name. Generic name is genus. Specific name is in species. Okay, they are Latinized in Italic Latin word. So, rule of binomial nomenclatures. There are different rules are made on binomial nomenclatures to avoid confusion, duplication, error, ambiguity in scientific naming. The rule of binomial nomenclatures was framed into different code. And in the what are the different code? That is your ICBN, ICJDN, ICVN and ICNCP. ICBN is your International Code of Botanical Nomenclatures. ICJDN is International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. ICVN is International Code of Viral Nomenclature. ICNCP is International Code of Nomenclature for Cultivated Plant. So different codes are framed to avoid this type of confusion. So in under the rule of binomial nomenclatures, we can discuss some about the rules which have come under binomial nomenclature. So what are the different rules of binomial nomenclature? Come to the rule of nomenclature. So there are various rules under the binomial nomenclature, but I have cited here some point to define about what are the rules come under nomenclature. Rule 1 is Latin or Greek language is officially dead language. So it should be accepted in the scientific name, and there should be no objections or no offense for some other language to be used. So the rule 1 is that the Latin or Greek language are given priority. All the scientific name should be written in Latin and Greek language. Second rule is name should be written in italics to indicate the Latin origin. To indicate the Latin origin, name should be written in italics form. Rule 3 is genus with capital letter and species with small letter. For example, I am taking the example of Oryza sativa. Oryza sativa. Here Oryza is your genus, sativa is your species. So the scientific name, always the genus with the first letter will be your capital, and the species name, the first letter will be in the as a small letter. Rule 4 is author should be in the abbreviated form. Whenever the scientific name is given, in the end the author name is written. Here I am giving Linnaeus, but and it should be in the abbreviated form. Linnaeus is written as a Lin in the abbreviated form at the end of scientific name and printed in a Roman letter. Fifth is your author name is based on priorities. Here, whenever any plant was given or any organism was given a scientific name, so it should be discovered by any authors. The first author who discovered that one, who find out that one, he was prioritized, and its name was given in a was prioritized. Its name should be prioritized first. So author name is based on prioritization. Rule 6. To avoid the confusion of two generic names, it should not in a kingdom, it can't be the same. The generic name should not be the same, but the species name can be same. Species name can be same, no problem, but the generic name should not be same. For example, mango is your Mangifera indica, and tamarind is Tamarindus indica. The two names, that is mango and the tamarind, the two plants. Their generic name is different. Here Mangifera, tamarind generic name is Tamarindus, but the species name can be same. So rule 5 say that the generic name can't be same, but the species name can be same. Rule 7. Reporting of species should be in the Latin description. Whenever we report the new species from any area, it should be written in the Latin descriptions. Now come to the rule 8. When the plant species is reported by the authors, it should be in the herbarium state. So what is herbarium state? It's the dried plant with reproductive part with reproductive part on sheet of paper. So whenever the authors whenever the author submitted that one, we should be easily and clearly visualize that part, that plan part. So it is designated by the type specimen. So the whatever the specimen is collected from the area, it is designated by the type specimen, and it is of various type like phonotype, neotype, paratype, isotype, lectotype, topotype. So many types are there. For example, what is holotype? Holotype is the it is the specimen that is published by the original author. Means it was discovered by the original author and published by it. That come under holotype. And what about the neotype? Neotype reveals the new specimen. In the absence of the original specimen, a new species selected from the location, new location, that come under neotype. So about the paratype, what about the paratype? The specimen cited with the original descriptions other than the holotype, that come under paratype. And iso means same. Okay, so what about the isotype? All the specimen as they collected at the same time is called as isotype. And about the concept of permanent naming is called typification. So what the concept of permanent naming of the plant is called as typification. Under the typification, all these come type, that is holo, neo, paratype, isotype, lectotype. And it should be, this specimen, it should be preserved in herbaria of International Botanical Garden. International Botanical Garden. All these specimens should be preserved. So this is all about the rule of nomenclatures. And today this lecture is complete. And we will go further with the next video. Till then, bye.